is about a targeted wage support program, especially for older workers in Germany. And I will present joint work with Shira Vandenberg and Gesine Stefan. Yeah, as you all might know, unemployed age 50 and older usually face several difficulties in re-entering the labor market. And one major problem is often the high reservation wage. Getting displaced, they do not realize that they lose their claims on seniority wages, and then often, have problems in finding a similar wage offer as before. And especially in Germany, they have very generous unemployment benefits and also very long unemployment benefit entitlement duration. So they often end up long-term unemployed. So the question is, to what extent can active labor market policy help? So in 2003, the German Federal Employment Agency implemented a targeted wage support program called Entgeltsicherung. Entgeltsicherung covered part of the wage loss if an unemployed worker aged 50 and older was willing to take up a lower paid job. Then part of the wage loss was covered for 2 years and paid directly to the worker and not to the employer like a typical wage subsidy. So this should give incentives to take up even lower paid job and for older workers to quickly find their way back into the labor market. However, the problem was that the take-ups of this policy program have been really low. And qualitative research thinks that one major problem was a lack of information on the program. So we implemented a randomized controlled trial and sent out this information brochure you see over here to randomly selected eligible men to manipulate their knowledge about Entgeltsicherung, to know the reasons for the low take-up and measure cause effect of this information treatment, which is receiving the brochure on outcomes of interest, of course, especially the take-up of the wage support program and the probability to find a new job. And by doing so, we are related to a growing part of the literature called the so-called nudging literature that uses smooth policy intervention to alter people's behavior without forcing them to do anything. And before I want to show you my results, I of course want to give you more information about the program we're looking at and the implementation of the trial. So, more about the wage support program. So, to receive Entgeltsicherung, you have to be at least 50 years old. And you have to have at least 120 days of unemployment benefits left. Then when you find a new job, the new monthly net wage had to be at least 50 euros below the old wage. And you have to apply for the wage support program before signing the new contract to avoid windfall. Then the Federal Employment Agency covers part of the wage loss. 50% in the first year, so the minimum amount is 25 euros, and 30% of the wage loss in the second year. And all payments, of course, are hours adjusted. So when you look at these entitlement conditions, Entgeltsicherung was not really a typical in-work benefit, like, for example, the earned income tax credit in the US, because it was not targeted at previous low-paid earner, but rather better-paid earner. So the question is, how should Entgeltsicherung give incentives to move back into the labor market? And I want to give you a simple example. So consider an unemployed worker that should be eligible for Entgeltsicherung if he finds a new job with a previous monthly net wage of 2,000 euros. Now he's looking for a new job. And here you see the density of the wage of the distribution. And what can we learn from that? Of course, if the reservation wage of an older worker is higher than his old wage minus 25 euros, then there is no effect. But if this is not the case, at least some wage offers become more attractive. The chip is pushed to the right over here, which should have a positive effect on the transition rate into work. However, if you are familiar with the theory, if there is an increase in the rate you receive your wage offers, workers might also get more selective. So we have two opposite effects, which means, we cannot really know the net effect, but according to the literature, according to Burdett, a wage support program that causes a location shift should end up positive. This is not really a location shift, but we nevertheless think that Entgeltsicherung could be a good program to bring older workers back into the labor market. Of course, the incentives might vary by age. Unemployed age 60 and older might have higher incentives to retire instead of getting back to the labor market. And also windfall might appear, meaning that workers take up the wage support program even without needing the incentives by end date. Yeah, and so we implemented a randomized controlled trial to know the reasons for the low take-up, whether there was a lack of information on the program, and measure cause and effects of an information treatment. And for that, first we needed data. So we selected a sample of currently unemployed men in June 2011 who should be eligible for Entgeltsicherung if a suitable job offer arrived. So they were at least 50 years and older, etc. We only selected men because they are usually in Germany, they have a higher employment rate and might also suffer more from a wage loss. We only selected non-stop employed at that time to make sure they have the full duration of unemployment benefit entitlements. And we excluded low paid earners as they are not the target group of Entgeltsicherung. And this sample of currently unemployed men is stratified by age group, type of labor market, whether an unemployed worker potentially lost his job due to a mass layoff. And from this sample, we randomly selected 2,600 men and sent them an information brochure to their home address on October the 1st in 2011. And this is our treatment group. And all of the others from our sample received nothing from us, and this is our control group. So in the end, we have the gold standard of evaluation method, a randomized controlled trial. However, what was not really in line with the gold standard was that while we were implementing the trial, the Federal Employment Agency decided to abolish the program. So you have to keep in mind that our workers, unfortunately, only had 3 months to find a new job, even though some of them were long-term unemployed. However, if we find something, then yeah, we can be sure it's due to our brochure. And Entgeltsicherung was abolished mainly due to the reason for the low take-up. To get the sample, we used registered data of the Federal Employment Agency, mainly the integrated employment biographies. They contain a lot of information on the workers we're looking at, personal characteristics, but their history also in employment, unemployment, active labor market policy programs. So using the registered data, we can measure, for example, the effect on the take-up of Entgeltsicherung or the probability to find a new job. But of course, we do not know whether the awareness of Entgeltsicherung increased due to our treatment, what they think about the wage support, or whether the job search behavior was affected. So we also conducted a computer-assisted telephone survey of randomly selected men from the treated and control group in August 2012. So in the end, we have both survey and registered data to analyze the trial. And when we analyze the trial, we first have to think about the causal effects we want to measure. And here we have to consider the following sequence. So first, an unemployed worker gets an information brochure or does not get an information brochure. Then he might have knowledge about the wage support program, if he reads the brochure or not. And he might behave in a world with Entgeltsicherung or not. Then he decides about his job search behavior. Maybe finds a job and maybe takes up Entgeltsicherung. So due to in one we have random variation, which can be used to measure causal effects of this information treatment, which is receiving the brochure on outcomes of interest. And usually when looking at information treatment, what the literature does is also using the randomization as an instrument to measure causal effects. More precisely, late local average treatment effects of taking up Entgeltsicherung on the outcomes of interest. However, we cannot do that because an unemployed worker might be affected in his job search behavior, find a new job, but he does not need to take up Entgeltsicherung. But we can also measure late local average treatment effect of knowing about Entgeltsicherung of labor market outcomes. So late means we are looking only at the compliance people only knowing about Entgeltsicherung due to our information brochure. Yeah, and what are our results? What's our lack of information on the program? Here you see reduced form all estimates for separate data outcomes. You can see that our information treatment increased the probability to be aware of Entgeltsicherung among all of the three age groups by around about 20 percentage points. So this is an increase of 30%, which seems to be not so much, but all of the workers should know about NCATS at home. So it seems that still a lack of information was one reason for the low take-up. Of course, there might be others. The exit rate, as you might all know, of older workers into the labor market is not very high, also of course not at that time. And this should be really taken into account when abolishing a program due to low take-up. Maybe also the targeted wage support wasn't worth applying for, but we asked it in our survey. 72% think that NCATS is a suitable measure to bring older workers back into the labor market. We also asked questions about the amount of money they get or about the entitlement duration. Around about 70% thought that it's really suitable. And of course, maybe not so surprising, more than 60% believe that a wage subsidy that is paid to the worker is better than a subsidy that is paid to the employer. However, kind of a little bit surprising for us was that even so, the unemployed do not need to tell their employer about the wage support program. They think that a wage support paid from the Federal Employment Agency might be a bad signal for their productivity. So stigma might also be one reason for the low take-up. Yeah, but what are our results for the take-up of NCATS and to find a new job within 3 months, the entitlement period after our treatment? BUC reduced from OLS estimates for registered data outcomes. When you look at the three age groups, you see that our information treatment increased the probability to take up NCATS for unemployed below age 60. This was an increase from 2 to 3 percentage points, which seemed to be quite a lot, but it's an increase of more than 150% for this age group. Yeah, older workers were not affected, maybe due to the stereotypes. They might be highest for this age group, or also they have higher incentives to retire. Of course, we wanted to know, was there not just only a take-up of the wage support program, but also on the probability to find a new job? Here you see, again, workers age 60 and older were not affected. And also workers age 55 to 59 were not affected. So this effect over here seemed to be pure windfall. And moreover, for unemployed age 15 to 54, we find a negative effect. So it seems that due to our brochure, they increased their reservation wage, got more selective, and had problems in finding a new job. However, when we look in the medium run until the end of 2012, this effect disappears, still no effect for unemployed age 60 and older, but we find a positive effect for unemployed age 55 to 59. So it seems that maybe they could manage to find a new job within 3 months, but due to their increased job search, they could manage to find it afterwards. Yeah. And I also wanted to show you a local average treatment effect of awareness on labor market outcomes. We used two sample IV setting. Here we suggested, when you look at WALT estimates, which are the reduced form divided through the first stage, to increase and remain their size. This is what we see over here. However, not all of the results are significant anymore. We think, yeah, we're a little bit puzzled with that. What we think is due to the relatively low number of compliance in the survey data. But to conclude, we sent out information brochures to know the reason for the low take-up of a wage support program and measure cause and effect of this info treatment. And we found out that there was a lack of information on the program because our treatment increased the awareness of NCATS around about 30%. We also increased the take-up of NCATS for unemployed below 60. However, part of it was pure windfall. And moreover, we found heterogeneous effect on the probability to find a new job for the older workers. For unemployed age 60 and older, we found nothing, maybe due to the incentives to retire early. Younger, older workers became more selective. However, for this age group, it seems to be that a wage support program can help them, yeah, to activate them, to increase their job search behavior in the medium or longer run, to find a new job. So when we think of implementing a new program to bring older workers back into the labor market, a wage support for this age group might be a good idea to increase their employment rate. So, thank you very much.
Okay, we are having good presenters in terms of time and many other things. Any questions? Yes.
Very innovative and interesting approach. Oh, and of course you suffered because of the discontinuity of the program. I have two technical questions. One, how did you select your control group? Did you just take a large number, or why didn't you, for example, use a method like propensity score matching to make sure that the control group is rather similar to the other group? And in terms of estimation, if you're estimating probabilities, you use OLS. Usually one does some nonlinear estimation, such as logistic regression or something like this. Could you explain this?
Yes,
thank you.
So regarding to your last question, we also did this, but didn't show the results. So the results didn't change, yes. And regarding the control group, if we randomly select the treatment group, then of course we have to check whether they are similar, and we check for this, and this was the same. Regarding the observable characteristics, of course.
How did you check them? In a formal fashion, or?
Yeah, you can just simple like do the propensity score to measure how to get the treatment, or just compare the differences in means of all the characteristics you observe of the treated and controls.
Any other question, comment? Yeah.
Thank you very much. I might have missed it, but did you mention what the alternatives for earning income or getting income, for example, early old age pension or disability or something else, were for persons who are 60 years old and older, which didn't have any, where there was no effect?
Yeah, so the workers age 60 and older could get pension due to unemployment.
What I've kind of guessed.
Yeah.
So that was a good explanation of why it didn't work. Okay.
Yeah.
Any other questions? I just have a curiosity. When you designed the project, the program, did you inspire in other countries or in other projects, or you just, how did you go to that particular project, particular program?
I don't know. What do you mean? Why
I mean, if these kind of things are, if you have seen other examples in other countries, or you just think about that and you design it ad hoc, or, I mean, this similar programs in, to foster all age, all workers employment.
So there are a lot of studies about the earned income tax credit, for example, and I think for mothers, they find positive effects, but it's this program we have over here is not really comparable to other programs.
Yes, my question was more in this line. I mean, if you have similar programs in other countries, like just subsidizing the wage of old workers to get them, do you know any other like that, or?
Especially for older workers, no.
Okay.
Thank not you. Yet.
So if you have no more questions, we move to the next paper.